4-point near.
Yeah, do 4-point near false.
Alright.
How do you do a 4-point near false?
It can turn into backwards.
Okay.
The longer you scramble, or a guy holds on to position, the more opportunities there are to put him on his back and throw the right things. Get in there again. Partner's giving him a good feel, hop over. Okay, from here, he hooks. Now right here, he's got a small window. If he doesn't separate this leg and keep this block, his knee's gonna come in, right? Do what you just did, make your belly. Go ahead and finish. Okay, you gotta make sure you keep this hand in there. So go back. Go back, start moving. This hip to his belly button. Okay, when you're gonna come up, go ahead, slide that hip all the way up, rotate high. See, there's still a window here. See this window right here? That knee, the moment you move your hand, that knee's gonna come through. So when you rotate, when you're ready to let go, once you take this hip, put it right on his belly button. Don't screw around. This hip to his belly button. This hip to his belly button. Where's his belly button? There, now you see him off that window. Now that knee can't come through. You're gonna catch him to his back. Okay? That's more important than trying to jump up on the head and rush him and push him, sealing that window up. Okay? The second one I want to just talk about is what if he doesn't take that foot high? Go ahead and get in there. Okay? He doesn't bring this foot in and that leg's out, all you're gonna do is simply change off to your double. Okay? Hop over to the other side and you're in that position. Alright? Should have brought that. That should have been our first finish. If he doesn't give us the right thing, we're going to take the easy takedown every time. All right, let's go back out there. Go.